So now coming lecture number 2. So we have topic force. Now I was teaching you what can force do. So force can make an object move, force can stop a moving object, and force can, okay? And the third one is the force can make an object, move in 190 faster or slower. So it means when you push a toy car, okay, when you will push a toy car, it moves, okay. Now when you push it harder, it will move more faster. Now when you will push a toy car slower, then what happened? It will move slowly. So that's why it says that force can make an object move faster or slower. Now next is, force can also make a moving object change its direction. Force can also make a moving object change its direction. So force can also make a moving object change its direction. See, it means what? When a bowler is bowling you and when you are batting, then what happens? A bowler will throw a ball straight or anyway, it will spin or it will come from this direction. And what? You can hit a ball by applying your force in this direction also. I mean, you can hit it in off direction also, you can hit in left direction also, or you can hit in a straight direction also. It means when a force can also make a moving object change its direction. When you apply force, you can change the ball direction. Now third is, force can also make an object change its shape. Force can also make an object change its shape. Okay? So force can also make an object change its shape. It means if you have seen a tennis ball, now when you will squeeze that ball, means when you will press that ball by applying force, because you have to apply force, then what will happen? The shape of that object will be changed. And when you will not apply that force, that object will again take its original shape. So we can say that if we apply force on an object, it can change its shape. Now see, this is hard. When I will apply, it will not change, so it will be hard. But I am just talking about a spongy things, that tennis cricket ball, okay. If you will take a tire also, when you will press it, it will change its shape. Now come to force due to friction. So first you have to know what is friction. See, we are able to walk, okay, with the help of friction, because when we walk, there is one leg front, one leg back. Again we walk, one leg front, one leg back. So we are able to walk with the help of friction force. So see, when objects rub or slide against each other, a force is created for friction between two surfaces. Yes. Now see, take me as an example, okay, an object. See, when I walk, I rub against surface. So that is when, so we are able to walk with the help of friction force. You cannot jump and you can walk, okay? You have to rub or slide. We are rubbing, we are pushing one back and going again back, front, like this. So we are able to walk with the help of friction force, or we are able to rub or slide against each other with the help of a surface, that is also a friction force. Now force due to friction slows down the motion of an object when it rubs or slides against each other another object. Yes. force due to friction also, it can slow down the motion of an object when it rubs, okay, when it will rub or slide against the surface, force can slow down the motion of an object also. It means if you have seen a trolley bag, okay, when you will see a trolley bag, when you take it with the help of rubbing on to the surface, when you are going, what happens? It slows down the motion of it. When we walk also, see, when we are running, we are faster. Why? Because we are not rubbing it. We are just putting and just again picking up. But when you are walking, we are rubbing. We are rubbing against the surface. That's why when we are walking, our movement is very slow. So force due to friction depends on the surface in contact. Yeah. You see, where I am standing right now, that is very plain surface. But when you will walk on concrete road, that is not plain surface. So force of the friction depends on the surface in contact also. The rough surface will have greater force. If the friction, that is smooth for surface, okay? If rough surface will have a greater force, okay, that there will be, see, in this plane surface, my speed will be not so much because this is very slight grip. I can slide it on, but when you will walk in a concrete road, that is not within the rough surface, there you can walk faster than the smooth surface. So, I am just talking about the friction. See, the force that slows, down the motion of an object, when the object rubs, slides against another object. Now we move to pin number 121. Next topic, the uses of frictions. What are the uses of friction? So friction prevents slipping or sliding of things. Yes. Friction prevents the slipping or sliding of things. It does help us in many ways. We are able to walk due to friction between the soles of shoes and the ground. Yes. So friction prevents slipping or sliding of things. Okay. And we are able to walk with the help of friction. Okay. Because there is a friction between our sole of shoe and the ground. So we are able to walk with the help of friction force. Okay? And we are able to hold a pencil if the friction between the pencil and our hand or else it would keep slipping. Yes. We are able to hold pencil, okay, due to the friction between the pencil and our hand, or else it would slip in. Okay. So right now I am able to hold this marker with due to the friction, because if otherwise it will, my marker will keep slipping. So this all due to the help of friction. So your chapter 11 is over. Now in next class I will go for next chapter, that is chapter 12, air, water and weather. So pronoun, good.